Hello, good afternoon. Thank you for joining me. My name is Nicole Digruber. I was a participant in the People for Ponds project, and this is just a wee presentation about how we were creating dragonfly habitat in the community. So I'm a mum of two lovely girls. I've been involved in volunteering for probably the last 6 years in various different roles. I've started with wildlife rescue and rehabilitation at a wildlife rescue centre, but eventually moved closer to home to volunteer in my local green spaces, where I got involved in two different local green spaces. This volunteering also first brought me into contact with dragonflies again, and they've been quite influential on my life in the last couple of years. And they've even inspired me to return to university again. I'm just finishing my PhD in countryside management, and I'm starting a new course in ecological surveying. So they've had quite an impact. So this is just a wee bit about our dragonfly journey and the work we have done as volunteers in our local green spaces. So one of the places that I was helping out with is Home Hill Woods Community Park. It is in South Lanarkshire, just south of Cambus Lang. It's a proposed local nature reserve with a variety of different habitats, from ponds, grasslands, shrubland woodlands. It's a beautiful park. Map suggests it was planted either in the late 18th or in the early 19th century. So it's quite a well-established site, although it started life out as a farm. Between 1999 and 2001, three ponds were created as additional habitats there. And in 2012, the Friends of Home Hill Woods Community Group was formed, and I've joined them a couple of years ago to support their efforts in the park. And they're really heavily involved in the management and organising events, cleanups. It's a very active community group. In 2016, they were working with Froglife to restore the ponds that were created between 1999 and 2001, because the ponds were quite grown over. So this project helped to open up the water and give some permanent water features, which has really helped out the dragonflies there. So I've put in a couple of impressions. One there is a big pond, and our other long pond. And as you can see, even the logo of the Friends group with a beautiful damselfly there. So as you can see in the pictures, it's a lovely habitat, not only for dragon and damselflies, but there's a lot of wild birds, amphibians, frogs, newts, toads. It's a very, very lovely park to be in. There's some more pictures taken from last year, the little moorhens on the rock, and some benches and some underwater photography, which we'd like to take forward, the wee water snail, and another impression from one of the lovely ponds. And the other side that I got involved in is from Grey Meadows. That's in South Lanarkshire as well, situated between Fernhill, Tapkin and Castleville. It's a proposed local nature reserve as well, one of quite a few parks in South Lanarkshire that are to be designated this year. It used to be a golf course for quite a number of years. Prior to that, it used to also be a farmland. The golf course then lay derelict for quite a few years, and there was not much use of the site, although some people were walking their dogs there. But in 2018 and 2019, significant improvements were made on the site. Nature Scott did some work with, I can't actually remember who else, but there was a lot of money invested to create a beautiful community park with a path through it, and making it much more suitable for the community. Habitats are quite varied. There's a lot of woodland, lots of wetland areas, marshy grasslands, and some wildflower meadows. The site has had quite a few draining issues over the years. So in 2019, two additional sats ponds were created, and they've been also some of the focus of our work to try and turn them into a better wildlife habitat. The Friends of Fernbury Meadows Community Group was formed in 2019 as well, just to have some community ownership of the park. And we started a community garden as well. And before the COVID pandemic, we did a lot of events and tried to work with schools to get a lot of different people involved in the park. So I've added a couple of impressions of the park here as well. You can see there's quite a nice viewing platform. You've got beautiful views across Glasgow. lovely benches. There are some cork and steel deer installations there. They're just beautiful. We have some standing stones, a wee dragonfly that came to visit. And you see there the wetland area, how it looks like when it's been raining heavily on site, although sometimes that kind of tends to nearly dry out. Here's some more. We've got a pond dipping area at the outdoor classroom site, which is very popular. So that's going to be a good observation point there. And then further up the side, there are those lovely dragonfly seeds that you can see in the bottom picture. There's dragonflies and the ladybug, very popular picnic area. And we've had a dragonfly land on a dragonfly seed, so that was pretty good. And then it's got beautiful boardwalk alongside the wetland area as well. Lots of birds are sitting in the trees. We've got bird feeders up there too. So it's a lovely site, and it's had a lot of visitors, especially in the COVID pandemic. The park is heavily used. So in 2019, Andrea came to visit both sites as part of the People for Ponds project. So we took her around both places and observed it for what dragonfly habitats there could be and where improvements might need to be made. And so she left us with a lot of suggestions and ideas of how we could work on the site. And she'd also suggested we should all take part in a training session to just learn a bit more about how to identify dragonflies in the wild. So we did that at the end of July at Reedley's Urban Park, which was a brilliant day, very lucky with the weather as well. Andrea took us through all the different species that we might be able to see. We got some chance to observing some of the damsel and dragonflies in the wild. We caught some in the nets as well to be able to observe them closer. So that was our first kind of proper introduction into the world of dragonflies. And we haven't really stopped looking at them ever since. So taking forward from that training day in 2019, at Home Hills Woods, there was weekly health walks happening on a Saturday morning. So every day, every Saturday after the health walk was finished, we would actually stay in the park for another couple of hours to try and find more dragonflies and, you know, whatever else we could also find, but usually ended up with us around the ponds, see what we could find. The friends group there then also arranged monthly picnic events. One Sunday a month, we would all meet up with a picnic and tea and biscuits. And again, we would mostly be looking for dragonflies and other animals we could find. And then really, I have to admit, any other day that I had some free time, I would end up with the camera at the points to see what was going on there. So here are some shots of our picnic days. You can see they were very popular with the children. They had a great time out in the park, and none of them ever wanted to go home. We did quite a lot of actual pond dipping, just playing around in the grass, trying to see what we could find. It was a very good social opportunity as well to have interesting conversations. And it was a really good way as well to communicate with other park users, because they would stop by and find out what we're up to. And a lot of them hadn't actually realised the variety of dragonflies that could be seen in the park. So I think when you're out walking with your dog and you're not always paying attention, then quite easy to maybe miss. So that was a good chance to also promote the work of the friends group a wee bit. So these afternoons were always great fun for everyone. And then, as I said, we were also pond dipping to see what we could find in the water. There's a lot of amphibians there, so you usually come across a couple of newts. But we also found out that we could find the dragon and damselfly larvae in the water, which was really interesting. And at that point, we obviously had no idea which one was which. So that kind of intrigued us as well to try and identify those, not just the adult versions. So in this year, 2019, we actually found 9 species at Home Hill Woods Community Park, which we thought was quite impressive. You can see there from the list of damselflies, we had the large red, common blue, the azure, the blue-tailed and emerald. But also on the side of dragonflies, we found the common darter quite a lot, common hawker, black darters, and also the four-spotted chaser, which there's a brilliant picture that one of the ladies from the friends group took. As with all the pictures, most of these are my own photographs, but I've put the people's names under the ones that aren't mine just to make sure they get proper credit for those. So we were really pleased that we found all those dragonflies, and it was really amazing to see the variety and the different behaviours, and it was just very, very interesting for us to kind of find these all. So that inspired us to go back to the Fernbury Meadow site, which wasn't quite as established, to see what we could do there to turn the habitat into something much better for dragonflies and damselflies too. So the Friends group applied for some funding, and we managed to get some money through the Action Earth grant. And we got a lot of native wildflower seeds and pond edge plant seeds that we got a lot of volunteers out. We had some brilliant fun days in the late autumn, early winter to get those seeds out. And the wildflower meadow actually turned out reasonably well. What we found a lot more difficult was to get the seeds to take around these overflow ponds, because they're so quickly overflowing one day and the water drains out again the next. So we haven't really figured out yet how we can get better success there. And then obviously last year we weren't able to kind of go back out. So that's something that we're planning to do maybe this year or next year to kind of improve that habitat there as well. So in 2020, it was a wee bit more difficult to continue with all our activities because obviously with the coronavirus we weren't allowed. But on our own, we still ventured out for our daily exercise walk to see what we could find, because we were really interested to see if we could find all those 9 species again. So the other thing as well was that once you get to recognize a species and you know what it looks like, you actually start to come up with a lot more questions about their behavior. Where, what do they eat? How do they hunt? How long are they in the water for? Where do they lay their eggs? What time of the year are they emerging? Just one question always led to another and another. And as you find out more, you're also left with more questions. So 2020 was a really interesting year that way, of trying to find out more about their behavior, about their life cycle, and about their needs, what plants they hide, and also what's the best way to take photos of them. So you get used to their behavior. Like the four-spotted chaser had his favorite place to sit. So you knew if you'd accidentally chased him off from where he was because you approached too close, you could sit there and hide, and eventually he'd come back. So that was quite a lot of fun, actually, in 2020, even though we were only allowed out on our own. But to be fair, the ponds were actually really busy with other families and other people doing their daily walks. So I did have a lot of opportunities to speak with these people while they were at the ponds and talk to them about dragonflies and everything else they could see at the pond, and also actually promote our picnic day. So hopefully once things return to a bit of normality, more people can join us. So as I said there, we wanted to see if we could find our 9 species again in 2020, and we did. We found evidence of all the species again, same as the last year. And one of our focuses was as well to see if we could find evidence of breeding behaviour, so that we knew they were actually using these ponds year after year for their breeding cycles. And then we did manage to see that, which was really, really brilliant. So I've got a lot of photos, which you can never have too many dragonfly photos. You see them there, ovipositing, quite a few ones, and that's the four-spotted chaser on his favourite spot. And this little emerald damselfly was rescued from a spider's net. I couldn't walk past it when I saw it. And then here's a wee bit more on the left side. There's a newly emerged tenoril. So that was, again, something else that we got to know in 2020 about how they're emerging, what time they're coming out, how to even look at the exuvia, and maybe even be able at one point to identify the species when you find it. So there was a lot of interesting things happening in 2020. And here again, some more beautiful photos. So I see we've all got a wee bit addicted to photographing damselflies. I think I need a special laptop now to store all these photos. Lovely red, large red damselfly there, and then a store on the right. So our plans going forward, I really would like to continue to monitor and observe the dragonflies and damselflies on both these sites. Especially for Fernbury Meadows, we need to ensure that we actually improve the habitat and see what work can be done to make it a better place for them. And also in home health, we need to just make sure that the ponds are maintained open, because they're obviously prone to closing over again with all the vegetation coming in. So that's something we'll be looking at with Friends of Home Health Woods. The other thing I had actually planned for 2020, but because of the pandemic, I didn't quite get around to, was to actually start transects at Home Health Woods, because we know they're there and there's quite a lot of dragonflies there, to start to formally actually survey the site and have proper transect and have good data that we can send in to Scottish Dragonflies. So that's on my plan for this year. And Andrea was very kind and helped me out with that and sent me the transect information and stuff. So I'm just planning this for this year. Fingers crossed that it's going to be a bit easier again this year. The other thing that I want to work on is the identification skills of the larvae and the exuvia. Well, we're quite confident now when we see the adult forms in the park. You get your eye in after a while and you can actually identify them from quite a wee distance away. But the larvae and exuvia, we want to get a bit training on. And I've also purchased some more books. I'm not sure if I can show these, but I've got quite a few of these ones here, dragonfly identification books, and they've been really invaluable. As good as the training sessions were that we had with Andrea, it's always good to have a book with you that you can double check and read up more information about them. So that kind of book goes everywhere with me. And then the other plan for this year, hopefully, if restrictions ease again, is to connect with more of the local people again in the community to share our passion about the dragonflies and maybe be able to have the monthly pond meetings again, and even start something similar at Fernbury Meadows. There's quite a lot of local schools as well that wanted to be involved. So we're just hoping that we can do this part of our work again soon this year as well. And last but not least, I wanted to leave you here with one of my favourite poems about dragonflies. I think it captures their behaviour quite well when you're looking at them from the side of the pond and you're marvelling out at their artistic flying manoeuvres, and then they're gone again. I just think it's fascinating. So what we're really hoping is that we can inspire other people to see these creatures the same way we do, and then hopefully that'll lead to better conservation and protection of the habitats that they require, which more people hopefully enjoy to see them. So thank you very much for listening. And if you have any questions, I'll be more than happy to answer them later. Thank you.